The next topic is regarding the normalization. And first of all, we should discuss why do we actually need normalizations. The topic name is normalization. Okay, so why do we actually need normalization is when we have some data, then in that data we can have a lot of redundancies, and because of these redundancies we can have a lot of different anomalies which can occur. Like we can have an insertion anomaly, we can have an updation anomaly, we can have a deletion anomaly. So we want to remove all these anomalies, and for the removal of all these anomalies, the schema refinement is required. Okay, so you can say with the help of normalization, we do schema refinement. Schema refinement. Okay, schema refinements means we are going to refine the complete structure of the tables which we already have. Okay, and this schema refinement is done to reduce or to remove the redundancy problems. Okay, so what are the redundancy problems we have? Number one is related to redundancy only, that is the insertion anomaly. We can have insertion anomaly. Second one is the update anomaly. Third one is the deletion anomaly, right? So we can have all these different anomalies, and because of these different anomalies we are going to waste a lot of space. Because of these different anomalies, they are going to lead to different, you know, problems. Number one, we are going to have a lot of wastage of space. We can have, you know, if you perform some action for this, the multiple insertion or deletions or updations are required. Multiple updations or insertions are required. Are needed or required. The third one is, you know, when we delete something, then deletion can cause loss of data. Deletion can cause loss of data. Okay, see, first of all, what is, you know, redundancy? Redundancy means if you are going to save one data multiple times, that is called as redundant. You are going to have something which is, you know, repeated several times. Right, for example, if you have a copy of the same data here, you have a copy of the same data here. Now, if you're going to perform some updation in this copy, then you have to reflect those updations in these locations also. Obviously, if you're going to store them multiply, then there will be a wastage of space, and you're going to require multiple updations or insertions. Now, if for example, there's a huge system which is related to this. And sometimes what happens is you perform some updation here, but due to some reason that updation could not be performed on this data item. Because of that, if that updation is performed here, it is not performed here. So the complete system will come into an inconsistent state. So that inconsistent state is caused due to these kind of anomalies, and which can cause an inconsistent state of the data items. Okay, so when we try to bring or when we try to normalize the schemas, then we are trying to remove all these anomalies. We are trying to remove them as much as possible so that we will not be facing any problems related to this. Okay, and to remove these anomalies, there's something which is required, and that is called as decomposition. And this decomposition is important, because decomposition means if you have a complete relation or if you have a table, decomposition means you may be required to divide this table into multiple tables. But the problem is, if you want to divide this table into multiple tables, then you want to preserve all the information which was stored here, plus you want this decomposition to be lossless. Lossless means if you combine them again, then you do not want any extra item or extra information which is not present in the original data. So that thing you do not want. So this is the case which we have to take care while decomposing these tables. And for that purposes, we are going to take the help of functional dependencies, or we are going to take, you know, functional dependencies, and this functional, with the help of these functional dependencies, we use normalization. Okay, and the main concept here while we are doing normalization is the functional dependencies. And we, if we can understand what is functional dependencies, what are the properties related to the functional dependencies, then you can easily see in different normalization techniques, like we have a first normal form, second normal form, third normal form, BCNF, 4NF and 5NF. In all these normal forms, the whole game is played with the help of functional dependencies only. So before starting normalization, I'll start with the basics of functional dependencies. I'll tell you what is a functional dependency, what are the properties of some functional dependencies, or what are the operations you can perform on these functional dependencies, and what are the new information you can find out from these given, already given functional dependencies. And then we are going to categorize it, and then we'll take normalization and we'll see the applications of functional dependencies in normalizations also. Okay, so first of all, we'll start with what is the basics of functional dependencies.